On almost, but not quite, a weekly basis, I have patients coming back who've had neoadjuvant therapy. Now, the majority of time, it's neoadjuvant chemotherapy, but now we also have patients on neoadjuvant anti-hormonal therapy. So the question then logically arises, what do we do about the lymph nodes in that set of circumstances, namely neoadjuvant therapies? I'll give you my view of this. On the national level, I must tell you we're debating this really pretty vigorously among those of us who specialize in the field. And as a matter of fact, there are even different approaches sort of up front on this very subject. At my location, I think many locations in the country, breast MRI is very important prior to beginning neoadjuvant therapy. Often based on that examination, ultrasound, or the physical exam, if we find that somebody's lymph nodes are abnormally enlarged, we'll core or needle biopsy those as a way of proving that they're positive. In my location, and again many others in the country, following the completion of the neoadjuvant therapy, we repeat the MRI examination. And so, you know, the debate goes on and on. In those who are known to be lymph node positive up front by positive needle biopsy, there's two camps, basically. There's the camp that I'm in that believes you should do an axillary lymph node dissection to document what the degree of response has actually been in the lymph nodes. And if there's a complete pathologic response, that is a tremendous, important piece of good news. Now, with that, unfortunately, especially if you combine it with radiation therapy, is the increased risk of lymphedema, which every patient I know really deeply fears. Now, there's another camp out there that says, all right, do your follow-up MRI, and if the nodes have shrunk down, then at that point, do a sentinel lymph node biopsy. Now, remember, this is in those who are known to be lymph node positive originally prior to the neoadjuvant therapy. A lot of debate about how reliable the sentinel lymph node is in that set of circumstances that I've just explained. And clearly, when you're operating on these patients, you have to feel around and palpate to make sure there aren't any lymph nodes that are completely replaced by cancer, because the sentinel lymph node technique won't work in those lymph in that set of circumstances. Now, let me give you the other side of the coin. Let's say somebody had a large tumor in their breast, their lymph nodes were negative clinically by ultrasound and MRI up front. They then get neoadjuvant therapy, have a great response to that. Follow-up studies, the lymph nodes still look to be negative. Then I would recommend doing the sentinel lymph node technique in that set of circumstances. And there are papers out with that set of circumstances that suggest that after neoadjuvant therapy, that the sentinel lymph node biopsy is an accurate way to go. So that's a very long answer to a very complicated question. My advice always is, please, 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 be working with your multidisciplinary team to help sort through what's appropriate and right for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.